divine favor.
Yeah, and also you have to keep in mind a Blast Mage in this specific map. I've played a lot of Shokuden after GVG. It's one of the decks that I played the most because I actually enjoy tweaking it. Mm-hmm. So if this is actually Shokuden, wait, no, you did not. Oh, this is not Shokuden. This is not Shokuden.
Yeah, it's Mech Paladin.
Mechadin.
With
justice. are we going to see? Are we going to see the Cobalt Guardian? That's all I want to know. Am I gonna see the Cobalt Guardian?
Nah.
No, I was just browsing cards in my head, like, what are you talking about?
What is that crap? Oh, wait. That. Yes, that. Okay, so he's throwing out the... You know what? This is a really nice play because he throws out the Mechwarper as a sacrificial lamb.
Yeah, exactly. To play the Dark Knight on turn 3.
Exactly. Really nicely done by Colento there.
See, but I think Trump will... Oh!
Trump knows it.
Oh!
Trump says there's no Blood Knight here.
Nicely done.
But that Muster for Battle is going to do a lot of work, and there's no Blast Mage in sight. No Arcane Missiles, nor Arcane Explosion that I can see, so these 1-1s are going to be... They're going to be a pain for now.
And also there's the Mirror Entity, which is kind of dead draw in this situation. So Mechwarper and Snowdriver, that's it.
It is not a bad play at the very least. It doesn't even consume the coin, so you can still get your turn 4 Lotham.
Sword of Justice.
Okay, no, Colento, you have to school me in the ways of the Paladin.
Too bad for him that he already played the Master of Battle, like turn 3 for the Soy.
Mm-hmm.
Would be insane.
And now the fact that he's going... If Trump uses a Snow Trigger to the face, that really denies a lot of Colento's hand at the moment.
No, not really. I would just play this Sword of Justice, I think.
Yeah. What I like, though, about Blood Knight is that in an Oyotron metagame, it's still heavily effective. When you're expecting mech mages, an Oyotron gets, you know, dealt with very easily with Blood Knight. This is a nice moment for a Mirror Entity. You kill the 2-2, you kill a Mad Scientist, get a Mirror Entity out, and then give him a Clockwork Gnome that you take out.
Definitely one of the best draws you could have gotten.
Mm-hmm.
Well, if you plan to pop the Mirror Entity right now, but I think you have to. The problem is, I think you should sacrifice the two dudes for one Mad Scientist.
Yeah, but then Clockwork Gnome... Okay, yeah, I see what you mean. Instead of killing the Clockwork Gnome...
Yeah, no, I mean, you have to kill the Snowdrugger just to make value from... just to get the value from the True Silver Champion next turn, most likely. But if you play Sword of Justice, you can't really play the True Silver Champion in the upcoming turns.
Well, he's going to be just playing the dude here to get a 2-2. Which, actually, if you look at the board right now, very little things that Trump can do will get him the board back.
Yeah, that's right. And Colento played around the second Mirror Entity from the Mad Scientist. That's the reason why he didn't drop the Clockwork Gnome. So, nicely done by Colento here.
Yeah, well, and the Sword of Justice also would buff the minion that comes from Mirror Entity. I think it works that way, where it gets buffed and then Mirror Entity copies it
a
shield.
90s card.
That used to exist in Shokuden, but even before Naxx, I think.
It was like
that was pre-Naxx.
Coin, Knife Dragger, turn 1, Argent Defender, turn 2. Oh, GG, thank you.
This is a flashback from the 1970s. Yeah. So, he will give his opponent a 3-3.
Yes, he should.
I believe.
I believe that's the mechanic.
No?
Oh, that's interesting.
Because it doesn't work like Twilight Drake, it seems.
Yeah. Okay.
Wow.
Yeah,
what a mistake on my part.
Oh, I didn't see that. Yeah.
Oh! Crazy outcome!
Well, if only he would have sacrificed the Pilot Trailer first, and then he played minions.
I think he should have sacrificed it first anyway, because what if Doomsayer?
Yeah, that would be super bad.
I keep saying that every time, but it's just that one scenario.
It happened today.
Yeah, and you don't want to be the guy who's remembered for losing to a Doomslayer because he didn't ping before.
Yeah, but that deck feels like a great counter to Mech Mage.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to have to say that. Definitely it does. So maybe Kalento expected his opponent to go for Mech Mage.
You're definitely right with Kalento bringing some new twists.
I don't remember seeing him in a tournament after that. I've just seen him play standard decks that I completely expected. It's never happened so far. The only time where that happened was back in the Handlock metagame, where he just brought that all the time.
Job's done. So, the reason behind having Divine Favor in this Paladin is, I think, solely because of Rogues and Demon Rogues.
Did he just give him a neutral server? He gave him a Death Spite. Okay, he gave him a Death Spite.
Really? Okay, I didn't see it.
Oh, it didn't show up. It's just there's a Death Rattle with 2 durability, and I can't think of another weapon that has Death Rattle. I saw 4 attack, 2 durability. So it's Power Mace or Death Spite, but I saw a 4 attack. Definitely a Death Spite. Well, still a lot of damage coming up, but that 3-4, I mean, what does it really do at this point? Divine Favor is almost dead, but you're gonna get 2 cards out of it. Now 2 card draws for this. It's like an Arcane Intellect at that point.
Yeah, that's true. Well, the good thing about the spare parts is that you can easily empty your hand before you play Divine Favor.
Mm-hmm.
So that's good.
Ah, you could actually trade that 2-2 if you wanted, but...
Do you
want just... I wonder, because you could just use the weapon, honestly. It would be so much simpler.
Yeah,
just go for the face and... Because he's dead next turn with your...
With your weapon.
Just your Death Spite alone.
Yep. So you go face, right?
You don't have to, but I think it's as good as anything else. Like, nothing he plays... I mean, even a Flame Strike doesn't do anything.
In this game. Well,
have
really
to
nicely done by Kalento. Really, really nicely done.
Well, do you think he's gonna stick? Trump is gonna stick to his Mech Mage because that Paladin is now out of the way. Kalento got a surprise win.
Mm-hmm. You keep the sprint, that's for sure, in this opening hand. Because you play versus Control, so you need the sprint to you know, have the fuel.
Yeah. You need to have it at least for the time where you get prep, so you can actually keep going.
That's not a bad hand, but also not great.
It's missing minions. Definitely. Yeah, like you don't want to be in the position. You can't really go all in on a single weapon against Warrior because they tend to run, even these days, a Harrison Jones. So his hand is good, but it's mostly going to be good once the board comes out from the Warrior. And that's what I really like about Oil Rogue. I really like that. I feel like the complexity of the deck is unrivaled.
Okay, his hand is really awful now, right now.
Yeah,
the two draws were whiffles, so now it's really bad. That's the reason why Kalento played the Talnos, just to get that one more card, which can mean like a Violet Teacher, which will be one of the best minions against Warrior. That's interesting.
What would you have done? You would have played Kul'Tas, or...
Or maybe just the Armorsmith, I think. Like, most of the time, that Acolyte of Pain will almost get no value when you just play it without any kind of...
Activator,
or at least maybe a defense against... Well, so many things, especially when you leave a Talnos, like, with 3 damage backstab.
Now I don't understand why he played the Acolyte. Now that I see him play the Armorsmith with the Kul'Tas, I'm not sure I understand what the line of thinking was. Maybe he was hoping his opponent did not have Deadly Poison, but he didn't play any minions.
But when he didn't have... Well, there's like 2 options.
2 options.
Backstabs and Deadly Poison.
Yeah.
So I don't exactly like him.
It's not like Backstab would have been great anyway, because you give him 2 cards, but I still think that was a bit of a weird play. Now, this was a really early Blade Flurry to get rid of the damage, which... I mean, Blade Flurrying a Cruel Taskmaster and an Armorsmith means he definitely has a second Blade Flurry in there. Like, that's pretty much.
Yeah, everyone is playing double blade warrior.
Yeah, you don't have the choice anyway.
I really love double blade warrior in Nord Miracle because no one was playing two blade warriors, so you could have just, you know, play.
Yeah, you take people by surprise.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Now you can't because everyone knows you're playing double blade flurry.
Wow, double sprint. That's a back-to-back sprint if she wants to. Not that it's going to be very useful.
But you have so many cards you can't really use it.
You have
3, 6, 7, 8. So if you go, you have to chip off the armor. That's for sure. So maybe you have to use the eviscerate this turn. So next turn you can use sprint and you will have 3, 6, 7, 8. So 7 cards, 8 cards. Minus the coin and sprint, so 6, you will be at 10. So yeah, you do this. So you will...
He'll be exactly on the right card count.
No, he will burn one card after he will play sprint. I think that's way better than just do nothing. Well,
but
maybe...
Unless he finds something... Oh, that's not bad. See, Lothev coin sap.
Yeah, that definitely changes the game plan.
Yeah,
and
definitely.
And then you can play the sprint on next turn and draw into a prep and... play second sap on the replayed Sylvanas.
Yeah, he had a pretty wonky starting hand, but now that we look at this, the fact that he's got the double sprint already in hand means he's going to have the fuel that he needs to maybe get a really sick board wipe. I don't know that I've seen anyone play Assassin's Blade recently, which I think is kind of unfortunate. It's one of those cards against a deck like Control Warrior that could take them off guard because they might Harrison Jones something smaller, and then you could get yourself some amazing value. And he does not play Lothab. He goes for the 9-card draw.
Okay. Well, I kind of like it. He wants to keep that Lothab for a crucial turn when he will just ensure that his minions will stay on board and then he will play the deadly poisons. I mean, the Tinker... what's the name?
Tinker Sharpsword?
Yeah.
Do you prep sap to not burn a card? Because what if... I don't know exactly what he runs, but like a South Sea deck hand could be somewhat relevant for damage burst. And it also forces the player to just, you know, replay 6 mana to just play
something.
I don't
agree with that prep sap, you know? I would have loved to see the prep sap next turn. I think. Because now
he can still redo
Sylvanas,
it, though.
Yeah.
Can't he? I have no time for games. Like, Lothab's, it's not that amazing.
But you could have played, like, Pilot Shredder, Agent, prep sap. It would be the exact same, but you will be at 23 points of damage, and you wouldn't have to deal with the Sylvanas right now. So this turn you will have to play Lothab and Sap.
That it's Lothab and Sap like we planned for about 2 turns ago, but he decided to go for the sprint play.
That's why I didn't like the prep Sap turn before. It would mean that he will burn a card, but I think you have to do it to ensure that you can put 2 minions on board, and especially when one has Death Rattle, it will be super important. And you will still have now the second Sap, look, this turn.
Yeah, he would still have it, but he wouldn't have played the sprint, sadly, which I think he wants to see as option. I know what you're saying, but he played a sprint about 3 turns ago, which was probably the deciding factor in his line of play. Alright, well, 1-for-1 on Sylvanas here. That she ate up 2 saps. That was a crazy value, Sylvanas, honestly.
Mm-hmm.
Amazing amount of value he got off that one card. The rogue couldn't just let Sibler. But now she's high on mana, and that's generally what happens with rogue. Nowadays, oil rogue tends to hoard those cards. They keep them in their hand for the longest time, and then they dump them all in one massive burst.
Yeah. This is where preparation comes to full value.
Yeah, definitely. A second prep here would actually do wonders for him. He has, after all, only played one. He's only got 4 damage on board, which is not horrendous, but...
Final Teacher, kinda too late to the party. And he doesn't have the second Blade Flurry.
And that Whirlwind from Trump, dealing with Violet Teacher tokens amazingly well. It deals with Muster for Battle against Paladin, deals with the... you know, the tokens from Violet Teacher against Rogue. I really like the Whirlwind.
So, do you just Dagger, Backstab, Oil, go face? Or just Whittle, Backstab even, just Oil and go face with everything. I think that's the line of play. Oh!
Well, you can double S-side to kill Dr. Boom and then you remove some armor. Okay, that's okay. That's probably... It feels somewhat unsafe because he is taking damage, but at the same time, he is in a really good spot right now. Oh, Senjin. Very, very slow card here in Chum's deck. How do you feel about Senjin?
Interesting. Is he playing Belchers in this case?
I have to assume he is. I can't see anybody cutting Belchers for Senjins.
So if he's playing Senjins, then he's like, you know, super anti-aggro?
Yeah, definitely. Which...
maybe not.
There's
super,
no more
super,
saps, but yeah, I don't know. Well, let's see what comes out of this Shredder after Trump hits it.
Doomsayer!
Their hand is coming!
It's a warrior. It's a bluegill warrior.
Recipe, I like it. I like this a lot, but... it's Trump or worse. This...
oh! That kill on the SI7 agent.
Well, if he kills the second one, then he's done. That's nothing the rogue can do from that point.
Well, we'll see where the boombot goes, and the boombot hits the SI7 for the kill. Wow. Okay, Kalento's not even smiling this time. I said he smiled when stuff like this happened, but not this time. So we see the current board state is definitely just favoring Trump to an extent I can't even fathom. With that double whirlwind, double execute, whatever comes out is dead.
Yeah.
Like, it does not matter. So Kalento's gonna have to be very aggressive, hope for a good oil next turn, but it's just not gonna happen.
There's no way Trump can lose this game.
Players have been known to disconnect.
Don't even say that, dude.
Take it back. Take it back right now.
All right. Nobody has ever disconnected from Hearthstone. The servers are rock stable.
Thank you.
And Lizard Squad is not a thing.
God damn it.
All right. So, Armorsmith with Whirlwind, double execute. You get armor. You kill everything. You still have leftover mana.
Maybe shield block first.
Do you really need to?
Well,
I mean,
you can shield slam then.
Do you've got just double execute? Do you really need to?
Well,
I guess you could.
No.
I mean,
you're right.
I have no idea, man. Right. This is. It just feels like there's very little that could go wrong for Trump at this point.
No, you just play the double execute and send him. That's enough.
Ascension's just like, hey, what's up? Oh, wait, it's already over?
Yeah, that sprint wouldn't change much.
Double Tinker's not going to do much. And this is going to be it for the game. Those are Xurdrakes. You know, it's funny because Kalento did have quite a bit of minions. Earthring Farseer, double SI,
The
Auto Barber, double Drake. And he just got nothing until the bottom, about like the bottom 18 cards. So he had to draw towards weapon classes. He would probably prefer to keep the Harrison Jones for when he faces Rogue. But that hand from Kalento is actually disgustingly good.
Oh wow. This is awful. Without any innovate for Trump, this will be disastrous.
And there is no innovate, there is no wrath. And this Earthling Farseer. Actually, this is a card I haven't seen in a long time in Druid. Well, speaking of innervates. Speaking of innervates, there comes the innervate, so he's going to be able to get out at least a Shredder, which are essentially two minions together. Or he could Hero Power down to 2-1, I guess, and get out a Sludge Buster next turn. Yep, exactly what he does.
So, Spider-Man is still the best option here.
Yeah, I really like Trump's line of play last turn. A little bit more, he didn't want to innervate out the Shredder. Instead, he opts to wait for an innervate Sludge Belcher, which lets him cure very nicely for turn 4 Shredder, turn 5 Belcher.
Yeah, exactly. That's what you want with Druid. If you curve out with really powerful creatures for every single turn, you have the... That's the power of Druid. That's what you want. So definitely a good call from Trump here with the innervate Belcher on turn 3 instead of that Pelter Shredder, as you said. And also the swipe is crucial in
Swipe is going to be very important here because a lot of the time mages manage to get their minions to live with very little health. And swipe, when they do trade, swipe allows you to kill a blast mage, and you know, finish off mechs that might have a low amount of health.
Mm-hmm. Ideally, you want to kill every single mech that hits the board and just ignore the non-mech minions, if you can.
To deny the mech mage value.
Yeah, and the tinker value. Yeah.
But there's a point sometimes where there's so many mechs, like it's mech city here.
You pass the turn?
Is that, or you trade your 3-4s, 3 health into a sludge, and you still leave him with a slime, which kills your 3-4, so you essentially 2-for-1 yourself here. I'm not sure that's exactly great, but you've got to be worried about a potential swipe play, like if he attacks the Shredder. Yep. This is a marginal call, but I suspect it might be good.
Not exactly sure about this, but
It's a marginal call. It's the most marginal.
It's a very different call. I mean, not different, but difficult. Sorry.
Yeah. All right. So there's a 2-for-1 here. Nice Sludge Belcher. Although it did get innervated out, so ultimately it adds up to the same amount.
Mm-hmm.
And we see a cloak.
Wow. That's kind of important because you can.
Do you keep it for Archmage, or do you keep your Tinkertown alive?
I think you use the plate to basically do the same as with stealth. My first thought was stealth D4-4, but
I don't think you can Blast Mage. Archmage is such a power card when you have that.
But you have to. You will draw like 5-6 cards in this deck. Until the end of the game, and that's like, you know, 1-2. I don't know exactly.
I think he's gonna draw a bit more than that. I don't think the game is that close to done, unless I'm mistaken. This game doesn't seem like the Druid is able to set up.
Let's count the cards for now.
Okay, sure. Let's do it. I look at the Azure Drake, and I suspect he might play that. Let's make a bet. Okay, you make what? He says six cards.
Let's say 6 cards, yeah.
If you win, you get... What do you get? I don't know what you get. What do you get? What do you want?
I don't know.
I'm gonna give you, like, a virtual trophy.
You have to shave your beard and just leave the mustache on.
Oh, no. Oh, no. I can't do that.
Just for one day, dude. Just for one day.
One day. Okay. Oh, wow.
But... Actually, that's
perfect. Actually, that helps the mage at this point.
Druid of the Claw and Charter doesn't do kill anything. The totem.
Yeah, you have to kill the totem in this. You can't even taunt up.
Will he do it?
Oh, yeah. He has to. Okay, Trump almost roped. We had some life coach syndrome coming up.
Oh, Goblin Blast Mage and no mana for now. So, Drake, right? And that's the first card.
Do you know that the issue is right now, swipe is probably the most amazing swipe I've ever seen in my life. Kalento saw that. He's like, if I attack, it doesn't matter because he still has to make the trade. And I'm going to get swiped, probably. So he lets Trump make that call. You lose that succubus.
But... No, swipe. Yeah, it seems good. Then you trade the succubus. Succubus? No.
Succubus, yeah.
Yeah.
All right. If I see Hemet nesting wary, I think I freak out. Okay, it's not there.
So now you have to play an Oratron and Goblin Blast Mage.
Yeah, I mean, you've seen one swipe, and the Oratron protects you from a Wrath hero power. And it might even put the Druid of the Claw so low on health that it dies to an Oratron or lets you ping it.
Oh!
What?
Oh!
This is crazy.
Oh, damn it. Now, good call from Trump for having Farsu you here.
Trump is scratching his head like, okay, now I guess I don't heal my face. Yeah, it makes a lot of sense. You can't possibly justify it. Really, really clutch so, Farseer here.
You play Children of Time, Sphere Power, kill the Noitron, right?
Oh, yeah, you have to kill the Noitron. I mean, playing Sludge Belcher or Druid of the Claw, I don't think does much. I don't think it accomplishes much, but this game could still go either way depending on what Kalento finds.
Okay,
you know what? You might be right, man. 6 cards. You said 6. I think
now it's 4. Yeah, now it's 4.
You've been counting?
Yeah, I'm writing it down.
Okay. Wow, you want to win that bet? I forgot about it. All right, well... Kalento's still in a pretty good position, though.
Yeah.
Very good position, in fact.
Ooh. But
how
no.
long for though? Well, still. Trump
so
has to taunt to... up. I think Trump has to taunt up. Like, yeah. I'd like to say that he can afford Dr. Boomy here, but it feels way too risky. Since there's no taunt coming up. He can only kill one minion here, which is the Annoyotron. Unless he uses Drew the Clone.
I think you play Belcher, Hero mm-hmm. Power, kill the Annoyotron.
With a 3-3 and then...
That doesn't really make sense.
Well, you get two damage soaked, right? Soaking two damage with that slime here might be very important.
The Belcher will be the play, but I don't think you pop the Vanishing with your creature. You just pop it with your... you don't pop it with your hero power, you just pop it with two creatures, because that's the one point of health you really want to keep in this situation. And
okay.
I think it's more important than just dealing 3 points of damage to the face of your opponent.
Alright, that's a call I don't think I would have made, so let's see if that ends up mattering. I just thought maybe you keep the Shade Stealth to trade it up as it went into 4-4.
I don't think he's at this state of the game when you can actually not...
just not trade with it.
Yeah. Okay, so this is the fifth card. And now he has to use the Fireball on the Belcher, right? Fireball on the Belcher, go face for 5, or you just... No, you have to do it like this. You trade the Goblin Blast Mage for the Belcher, kill the little slime with your Spider Tank,
mm-hmm.
play the Snow Tracker, stealth the Goblin Blast Mage, ping the...
To keep it up, yeah, to keep it up and get even more value.
Ping the head of the Druid, and then you have Lethal with 2 Fireballs next turn.
That's a big stretch. This is such a power play though, because the Druid really can't do much to this board.
5, 8, 10, but that's not lethal next turn.
Oh, you don't have it, but neither does he. Neither does he have lethal.
I didn't really like that.
Ah, well now Kalento's in top deck mode, and unless he finds Dr. Boom, because even Archmage Antonitis is not going to do anything without a spell.
Well, you just play here, taunt up, play Farseer,
mm-hmm.
kill the...
And you stabilize for sure.
Yeah, and you stabilize.
Well, or you don't. Alright, well, let them play what they want. So how many cards do we have now? 6?
This will be the 6th card.
Okay. 6 cards. Right. So 5, 6, 7. There's no Savage Roar in Trump's hand.
Clockwork, no. So that's the 6th card. So he will draw probably the 5th. The 7th one, because he will not concede at this board state, I think.
Do you have to kill Dr. Boom? Or do you just ignore it and hope that you can go... I don't think you can afford ignoring it, but at the same time...
I think you go 5 for face and freeze Dr. Boom, but it doesn't really change much with combo mm-hmm. Savage Roar. So
exactly.
I think you just go for face with both.
This is kind of a situation where when Freeze Mage exhausts its options and it doesn't find its late game threats, this is pretty much what ends up happening. And it reminds me of the old, you remember the old aggro mage that was
Knife
Juggler and the Mirror Images and Sorcerer's Apprentice?
Well,
it kind of had that problem. It was even more top deck heavy, which...
But it had 2 Pyroblasts for 8 mana with 10 points of damage, dude.
Okay, not that old school. The post Pyro nerf.
I didn't like that at all.
Yeah, it wasn't really playable. I didn't like it much, personally. But it reminds me of this, when you're top decking and you don't have any card draw, you really are in a lot of trouble.
Oh, 4 points.
That is pretty strong.
So now, 3-4. No, that's no way.
Let's see what the Boombot does. But I still don't see how Trump is losing this.
Yep.
I don't think it's realistic to expect
so
him to lose.
So I will lose this bet.
By a really small margin,
but only by one card.
Okay, So you didn't really
actually,
lose it.
Actually, it's only because he played the Azure Drake and that is the additional draw.
Okay, you're right. You were totally right then. Then I lost the bet, legit. I lost.
No, it's draw already. Never mind.
It's draw? All right. Okay, cool. It's a draw. It's a tie.
Because of the Azure Drake, but
all right.
It's really funny, right? That the when you play that, having the coin is one of the most important things when you're playing rogue. Oh, Miranda on opening hand. That's never lucky. Never lucky, babyface.
All right, so Cogmaster, this is a pretty good start for Trump. I mean, it's not the ultimate start, but it's a pretty solid one. He's got a mech, he's got his mirror entity. Although, you know, that's a pretty dead card. You'd rather get Mad Scientist, obviously. It's still not too terrible, and I like the prep here. He's got... His hand is actually looking pretty solid.
Mm-hmm.
That's a lot of damage for a one drop.
Oh, yeah.
It's more than Leopard.
New Flame Imp.
Yeah. The no drawback Flame Imp. So is this a case of prep, sap, SI? Or is that just not worth it and you just want a Goblin Autobarber?
I think prep, sap is okay.
Because you only take one damage from the Cogmaster. So many. Sorry. Yeah, that's it. You take zero, actually, because of the SI. So you go like prep, SI, sap. You take zero.
Yeah, I agree with that. I really like this play.
Yeah, and then you still have the Autobarber as a follow-up. And Trump can't abuse the Mech Warper because it's back in his hand, so he has to replay it first. I really do like that. So Mech Mage is, that's a lot of face damage, but can be somewhat easily mitigated. Although that sap, again, another useful sap here for Colento. But after the first two, you're...
So Colento will be in a great shape if he draws the second prep.
Prep, yeah.
It'll be insane. Second prep,
you
right
are
now.
Not prepared. Yeah, that is crazy.
Or even backstab would be good.
Deadly poison with Tinkers, whatever. There's many things that work, but he wants to combo that Tinkers with one of his minions. Ugh.
Drake is also a great draw, but the thing is...
Backstab
is just... Oh.
That is not it. And now suddenly...
No,
all of a sudden...
It's so bad. He just go face with both. Because he will trade for with one of the creatures next turn. I mean, he will kill the water elemental with one of his creatures next turn. Just because of the oil.
Tinker's oil, yes.
Yeah, Tinker. You play deadly poison Tinkers, one of the creatures will have 6 attack at least. Then you kill the water elemental.
I don't know. I don't know if he will be able to kill it though. Because Tinker's sharp sword next turn. If you can't really justify doing it if he's already attacked with the water, Ellie. I don't know. It's one of those minions.
Why not? No, he will attack face just to freeze the weapon. Yeah.
There's one durability left. I don't know.
I think he will attack face with that water elemental.
Alright.
Or if he will play low tap, then actually he might kill the agent. If he goes for Mad Scientist. That doesn't make any sense.
No, there's no. I don't think Mad Scientist is exactly an amazing play, but
so
either way, this game is still for Rogue to be facing down a water elemental and not be too worried is pretty incredible. I like the position Colento's in, even though his hand size is quite small. Lotheb is going to be a bit of a problem, but if no Lotheb is played, then it's going to have to be a board trading play with the fireballs. And it is.
Oh, he's ready. Okay, that's not a big problem then. Backstep, not a really good draw right now, but I think you play the deadly poison and oil now.
You've got only one durability. How is that?
You dagger up first. So you attack for two.
But you can't because you don't have mana then.
Oh right. Oh sorry. Wow. Bad.
No, it's a really big play here that he has to make because next turn he's gonna try to saturate his mana no matter what, with either a sprint. Or a combination of Dagger Up, Deadly, and Tinkers. Definitely.
It's a tough call, I think.
Alright, maybe just going face and trying to burst down your opponent with Deadly Poison Tinkers next turn after killing that Water Ellie might work out. Because if he's not frozen, it could work. He could be able to push the damage.
He has to sprint next turn.
He can't. Lothab comes down.
Too bad for you, dude.
It's like
you had a plan? No way.
Rest in peace. Down. Rest in peace. Oh. This is like
double sprint for 24 points of mana. Yeah, sure. I will wait 800,000 turns.
Where's your innervate now? Oh wait, cost me 5.
You mean the preparation?
Oh yeah, the prep. Sure, whatever. Innervate, prep, same thing. Different classes. Different classes. One is broken, and one is not.
Yeah, that's
that's the difference.
That's the difference. Yeah, like most of the time, innervate means you win ball control, and prep just allows you to tempo swing.
Mm-hmm. What I really think though should be done with this game at the moment is really like nerfing Dog Kaboom to a 6/7, because I think it deals way too much damage. This card coming down right now for Trump is going to obliterate any dreams that Colento had of.
You mean it's turn 7?
Yeah, the turn 7 Dog Kaboom.
Oh, what does it mean? Oh, let me guess. It's Trogzor.
Yeah, it's Trogzor, the Earthmater, obviously.
Yeah.
Alright, so let's see what happens here. We have a pretty high... Like, there's a hefty amount of mana, a sizable amount of mana for Colento to use. He can use Backstab, Deadly, Tinkers, and the SI all together. He can use all of that at once. But the problem is, if he is frozen...
Where is that deadly... that Blade Flurry when he needed?
Mm-hmm.
Can you afford taking so much damage next turn? You can't really, right?
What you have to do, I think, is... 7, actually, 12, no, you can't.
14, you 20... No, you're dead next turn.
Colento has to go... Has to go face? Then again, there's no way he wins this. Between the freeze and the...
If he plays sprint, draws a Blade Flurry with... Prep doesn't change anything? I don't think so.
I know, I really doubt it. No, you have to backstab Dr. Boom and take like 25,000 damage. Okay,
yeah,
he just goes
now he's dead. Yeah.
He plays for the win. I like what he did. It's an honest, straightforward play, but it didn't work out.
That would work the last game before, not this one.
Yeah, this time around, that was way too crazy. This amount of damage output, and I mean, Dr. Boom's boom bots weren't even important here.
So, very important win for my son, for Trump here.
TSM, yeah, he wins the series.
Cloud9, 1-0. Nicely done.
Yeah, TSM having...